Today we have a special guest on the Cooking with Kate and Kenya show. It is my favorite guest of all, the man, Johnny Brooks.
Hey, what's up? Today, I'm going to talk to you about the most important thing about grilling meat. You may think that your choice of charcoal is pretty important, but it's not all that important. Take this charcoal, for example. No special flavors or anything. Just came from the forest. In fact, some people buried it in the ground and burned the wood to make this charcoal. Some people think that the proper lighter starter fluid, whatever you call that stuff, is. Nah, you just need cardboard. Take a piece, shove it in the grill, and it burns because it's cardboard and it starts to charcoal on fire.
Don't you need fire first?
Okay, you may think that the most important part of grilling is the grill itself. Well, you'd be wrong. Because you can get a fancy smancy grill that costs thousands of dollars or hundreds of dollars. Or you can go to a guy on the side of the street and have him make a grill for you. Crank, hold on. Special tool. Everyone needs a wooden spoon for when grilling. Ta-da! You may think the most important part of grilling is all the cool accessories you can buy for your grill, but that just clutters up stuff. All you need is an apron, so you don't get grill juices on you. Grill juices are yucky. You need a fork, because meat is heavy and hot when it's grilling, so you can't just grab it with your hands, so you need to poke it with a fork.
Oh, you need bear claws.
A pair of tongs. We have bigger ones, but the small ones actually work better. And you need something to put the meat on when it's done cooking. Okay, before, you know, I put all this charcoal here and did my lighter fluid cardboard stuff, I cleaned the grill, because I never clean it after I cook. I always clean it before. So it looks pretty clean. Don't look too close, because you're supposed to be far away with the camera. But anyway, it's actually clean because it's hot. You know, hot stuff equals clean. You know, if you're grilling at home, like I am, you may want to smear some oil on the grill, but I'm kind of lazy, so we're not smearing oil on the grill. Plus, we're grilling pork, so it's pretty oily already. That's my official cooking advice. Okay, you may think the most important part of grilling is the meat. Well, admittedly, it's pretty important, but not that important. Some people do all kinds of fancy stuff, like marinades and things, like my wife, but me, I just take a plain old piece of meat, drop it on there. I got two pieces of meat because I have no idea what, but we have a lot of people, so I guess that's one. You know how I mentioned I don't put fancy marinades and seasoning on the meat? All we do is we put barbecue sauce. In fact, this is barbecue sauce from America, which is a bit expensive here in Kenya, but well worth it for our Christmas lunch. This is the basting brush, which somebody either sent to us or brought to us from America, I can't remember. Mm-hmm. But the, whatever these things are,
bristles,
used to be longer. So whenever I was basting, it would flip. You know, it's kind of like flip. I don't know what you call that. But anyway, barbecue sauce went all over me. So Kate, being the crafty person that she is, cut them. You kind of see how they're not even, which is a weird bummer, but you know. Now remember, the most important part about grilling is that it's incredibly boring. And all you do is sit around, because I can't just leave the meat, because a dog could come here and eat it, or a giant bird could fly from the sky and eat it, or a hyena or something. So you got to stand around and guard the meat. So it's best you have some Pepsi. This is Pepsi Max, for those of you thinking I'm too fat. So there's no sugar there. My wife is prejudiced against fat people, so I have to... I'm trying to reduce by drinking Pepsi Max. You put a little Jack Daniels in there. And pretty soon, after a while, you won't be bored anymore. Now we've talked about the most important thing in grilling is that it's boring, so you gotta take measures to, you know, livening up the place and all that stuff. You may think it's strange that a missionary drinks whiskey while he's grilling, but just keep in mind that as long as you don't drink drink the whole bottle, things will be cool. You know, there's this thing that somebody in the Bible talked about called self-control. And if you practice that, you're cool. And you won't be bored. Old meat juices. So you just flip over the meat like that. Look at that, looking beautiful. You get your fancy silicone basting brush, rub it on the barbecue sauce, and baste away. And that is how you barbecue.
That's how you barbecue. That's not how I would have done it.
Well, how would you do it?
I would have first put house seasoning all over these ribs, by the way, which is sea salt, garlic, and some black pepper.
Boring.
And then I would have barbecued them with a homemade paleo sauce, by the way. Yeah.
Yeah, this actually is not a paleo barbecue sauce, so I'm sorry. I'm not a paleo evangelist, but I do enjoy paleo foods. But this is part not paleo, and if you want to come over here and shoot me for that, go ahead.
Look how beautiful those ribs are.
Now, you may be thinking this looks good and ready to eat. It's not. It's still raw on the other side. I just flipped it. Okay, you may be wondering and asking yourself, like I oftentimes do, how do you tell when the meat is ready? I have no idea. Every single time I grill, I just guess. And 80% of the time, I'm right. Other 20%? The microwave! Yeah, meat's still cooking. Like I said, it's pretty boring. So I'm continuing to drink my Pepsi. Still boring. Okay, you may be wondering to yourself, why would people taking care of orphans and other hungry people in Africa be cooking this expensive meat, because pork is expensive in Kenya. I mean, not like exorbitantly expensive, but more expensive than goats. Well, one of the things that I thought would be great whenever we took in the kids was to give them stuff they could not get anywhere else. And so we cooked pork for them, and chicken, and cow, and what else? Fish, because they deserve it. Now begins the constant flipping and basting until I guess that the meat is done. All boring stuff, but someone has to do it, and since Kate refuses to do it, it has to be me. All right, here we are cutting the meat. And wow, that looks beautiful to me, actually. What do you think, Emma?
Beautiful.
Can't believe by doing nothing, I made meat that looks this delicious. All I did pretty much was start a fire.
Start a fire, sit and wait, and paint.
Yeah, paint some barbecue sauce on there.
If the baby likes it, it's got to be good.
I like it.